Welcome to At the Buzzer. Today we're going to be talking about Sap Shenanigans, Super Pudge, and who are the bigger druggies, the Blazers or the Cowboys? I'm Bobby Morales. I really feel like the Cardinals were the strongest team overall in Major League Baseball throughout the whole season. It certainly would have been a shame to see them wind up bowing out to a Houston team that was good at one point during the season, but really struggled to come on.
I mean, I do like Indiana's team defense. I think they got great individual defenders in Jermaine O'Neal and Ron Artest, who I feel could shut down anybody in the NBA. But overall, they just don't have enough depth to be able to compete with those West Coast teams.
You can't say it's once, it's four. I think that right in the nick of time, just like when Jeff Van Gundy left the Knicks, in the nick of time he did it. He saw this organization was going downhill. Ricky Williams bailing out on them was the first thing that went wrong.
He didn't knock him down, he didn't knock him out, but I mean, the momentum was his throughout the whole fight. When it came down to the end, the judges, all three of them, scored a unanimous decision for Sugar Shane Mosley, 115-113. That's not even close, you know, so that just went to show me that they have got to change the way they score. Elway at the quarterback position, but they did not win the Super Bowl without him.
Why? I'm not even going to go down that road.
What road are you taking then?
The fact that you said he played.
Which was one of the weakest positions in the league. The center position. Now that power is shifting towards the East with a guy like that, in which the East, the centers are really, really small to begin with. Guys like Kurt Thomas for the Knicks are playing the center position when he's really a power forward. Obviously, that shifts it. Though Greg Maddux is a great pitcher, he's been tailing off in his past few seasons, and that's why the Atlanta Braves weren't afraid to depart ways with him, whereas Roger Clemens right now is still at the top of his game. He's aging and yet still on top. He's just like
Greg Maddux may not be.
The Rangers are 10th in the Eastern Conference despite having the highest payroll in the NHL. They add another big contract with Yadier Yager at 11 million. He's, you know, owed about 11 million per year. But I mean, it's in terms of talent, it's a smart move to get a player of his caliber. But the Rangers are really in a rut right now. They have 3 wins in their last 12 games, and their upcoming schedule doesn't seem to benefit them at all in terms of a push for the playoffs.
Welcome back to At the Buzzer, your new favorite show on the Ham Channel. We're going to do a little name association right now, so I'll kick it over to Roy to start things off.
Bobby, I want to know first thing that comes to mind when I give you these names.
Right.
LeBron James.
Spoiled.
Marv Albert.
Yes.
Albert Pujols.
Amazing hitter.
Miguel Tejada.
Crybaby.
Kobe Bryant.
In deep trouble.
Roberto Alomar.
Oh, choked for the Mets.
Max Kellerman.
Great boxing analyst.
Patrick Ewing.
Great player. I'm sorry I didn't get a ring.
Rory Duhon.
Mr. Fairfield.
Yeah.
Right now, the Raiders are in turmoil. They're 2-6 on the season. I mean, there's so much bickering going on between Callahan and Woodson, people pointing the fingers. It's about time that someone stepped up and just said, we got to go out there and play football. That's what this game is all about. Let's get focused. Let's get this team unity going on and go do our job. Pedro is a young guy compared. Hell, he's like Hercules compared to Zimmer, who looks like he's going to be on life support any day now. And, you know, he could have sidestepped him easily.
Oh, definitely.
Or, you know, even, you know, gave him a gentle shove. But this guy, he thinks this is a WWF or whatever they call it nowadays.
It was not a surprise to me. I expected the Jets to be good this season. Two, you said that we didn't beat a lot of good teams this season. Well, I think that's the mark of a good team. You go out and you win the games that you're supposed to win. And that's why they're getting the job done. Secondly, our offensive game, in terms of the passing, hasn't even started to click on all cylinders. Guys like Santana Moss and Justin McCarron haven't even begun to blossom. When they do, I say it's definitely over, because Curtis Martin is playing like he is a rookie and in his prime.
Arguably one of the best teams in baseball on paper statistically. Why? Because there's no salary cap in baseball, and this puts the weaker teams at a disadvantage because they're not generating the funds
in order to go out
and get these big name players.
Exactly.
The Yankees, you know what, they can probably go out, get Beltran and Randy Johnson
because
of what's going on.
Now, I don't want to say baseball's been on the decline, but it certainly has been in a stagnant, you know, area at this point in time. Football is the kind of thing that gets people excited. Sundays, they're going to be missing church just to watch football.
Get people excited.
There's Super Bowl parties.
When the Yankees are playing the Red Sox,
when was the last time you heard of a World Series party?
Oh, it's got to be the Jailblazers. I mean, this This team is unbelievable. They might as well be called the Rikers Island All-Stars. You know what I mean? Between Stoudemire and Rasheed Wallace, the whole reefer thing, they must be listening to too much Styles P. I get high, high, high. I mean, come on now. 1994, when the Knicks were in the finals, John Starks was unbelievable that year. And unfortunately, everyone bashes him for like the game 7 where he shot like 2 for 18 and like went 0 for 10 behind the 3-point line. I mean, it's not his fault. Pat Riley should have taken him out. Because if you're going to live by him, you're going to die by him. And so I see the same circumstances right here.
Exactly.
You know, you got a top gun, you're going to go with them. Some nights are not going to have it. But you cannot put that blame on the player. It's got to be the coach's decision.
However, let's all be real here. Dengai is the engine that makes
Definitely.
This team run.
Without Dengai, you can't
if
win.
There was
mean,
a
win
Mr. Stagg,
a lot harder.
If there was a Mr. Stagg, his name is Dengai, and he's from the Sudan.
Baseball is supposed to be America's pastime, and we can't even represent our country. What is the world coming to? Who they lose to? Mexico?
Mexico.
That's the
sad.
Land of football.
Priestones pretty much leads the league in rushing on the AFC side. I mean, he's the man. Then you got, of course, Tony Gonzalez over the middle. You can throw it to him anytime, and he's going to score a touchdown. Johnny Morton's starting to get into the mix. He didn't normally score touchdowns before, but he's catching them.
But they've been up against juggernauts like the Lakers, you know what I mean? What are you going to do? They just don't have the matchups to compete against the West Coast, but they're getting there every year. Why would you fire a guy who's successful? And better yet, you need to have an alternative there who's better than the current one you have, and they didn't.
Yes, you can point the finger at him. You can never leave too much time on the clock. It's the big no-no. You do not want to do that because anything that can happen will happen, and it did.
That about does it for us here at the Buzzer. Signing off, I'm Bobby Morales.
And I'm Kyle Ottenbach.
And we'll see you next week.